Well, I'll keep this up quick. Justin North, Matt, IMG, or Independent Verification Validation Program. A colleague here with me today is Matt Grubb and Steve Yoku, back there in the back. Basically, what I'm talking about is finding these uses of CFS. So I'll give a little introduction here at the beginning, then I'll go into the four areas we use for flight system. So I'll get a little brief over IMG's involved the entire time. Talk about sort of the simulator that got us involved more than the dynamics. Build further we did for CFS, the aspect of that, and then finally I'll conclude with the simulator flight one, CubeSat mission. Just go through some high level stuff on each of these. I think to mention for each of these four subjects, there's a lot of materials and documentation, the manuals and so forth. So if you are interested in more details, you can go to this too. Verification and validation program is located in Fairmont, West Virginia. It's part of code 18. They provide customers assurance their software, mission-critical, mission-critical software operates reliable, safely, and now secure. Many advanced systems and software engineering principles. Website if you're interested in doing much marketing stuff. Innovative abilities. So that's the team. Basically, what we do is develop simulators. Software only, particularly hardware and loop systems, the lighting of these teams, so we can embed software. We obviously look manually, statically, and dynamically. We do this through the development or acquisition of systems. Currently, we have 9 active missions. We have acquired or developed sims for, spanning SLS and UTD with the Socrates. Working with here now, GPM, we did, Discover, so forth. About this. They are all the software only or all digital environment. So we have a lot of experience in seeing how different folks across the agency and outside the agency are tackling the problem of developing full up digital twin. There's another mission I will go into that basically we use a lot of visualization and modeling to do our work. We do that within a lab. As far as IMD performed on missions, utilized CFS, as Alan said earlier. We were involved with LRO, MMS, and we've never required desire to do the best analysis on all of these missions. Always trying to get better and improve, things are used, how to use the right assurance to basically satisfy that everything will cooperate correctly and safely. Simulators, one of the simulators, so this gives you an idea of what team does. Basically, what we do is create a digital replication if we're doing something in-house. We're using something like Socrates, for Lockheed, for some of your Maven and Airwax projects. So that would be the sale of a physical flight system or spacecraft. We do use an emulator. We use wind river simulators quite a bit, so we model down to the register level. We utilize that basically so we can run the unmodified flight software binary. For independent, we like to make sure it is unmodified. We want to test what you're going to fly. So, most cases, the experience with the hardware modeling ourselves, the kind of niche skill set. We came all the way in the last 6 years from when kind of forming Virtutech to really applying our understanding of how to do that effectively. Also, again, instrument simulators are going to be external or integrated or ourselves. We have some sort of ground system. We generally incorporate the ground software, the interface, assist, ICOS, and so forth. We have a core flight system for this simulator. We actually obviously use core flight system because the mission did. That was incorporated. We were able to run the binaries from Greenbelt simulator and actually verify requirements to test. We can look through the code. That's burdened by a lot of utility because there's limited resources, as folks have mentioned in previous presentations. So incorporate some sort of dynamic. Folks have used TRIP 42 today. We use in this case the Goddard dynamic simulator to provide that external input. Capabilities are there. Mentioned some of those. The big thing is all digital. With these systems, we've been able to inject errors in any aspect of the system. We can do hardware. too, so we can kind of see how the system levels, how they're being tested at integrated level versus just a unit, to help us create our work. We're just an architect, and I explained a lot of this earlier. The ground system interface, some sort of desk calculator, that can do in-house middleware to basically take care of all the simulated buses, 1553, and space wire, is what we currently use on this mission, and then we configure your instrument simulators, basically the entire flight software, response. Years, years, that's where my focus. So doing work there a few years ago with CFS, basically in the fact that I need to continue to look at these products, you know, multiple times, it's fun to come out the door. I wanted for a more automated mechanism to exercise the built system test of CFS. So these are the main machines, these are the sole procedures. They're usually packaged with the CFS. So you bring up the ground system, run it, volume results, bring everything down. So I mean, to do that more efficiently, not require us to look at all the tests and so forth, and really familiar regression testing. Going to support multiple target platforms. One ability, not only the test, you know, Linux or certain, or one that shows the ability to do multiple target platforms. We had 250 and Linux, basically just to show you. So here's architecture. They have two virtual machines. It shows a build-driven virtual machine. Some earlier mentioned basically use Bamboo to coordinate all this. I've got a video too for you guys later. Basically, walks you can actually see all this run with Bamboo. We developed a custom Bamboo plugin, basically to tie everything together with CFS. So we have the ability to start and stop things during execution. Linux flight software, core flight software, from the build server, and also the RAS-750 target. That device for communication and linking between the two. And then you have the assist virtual machine, basically, which has assist installed, has all your tests in it, so you can feel for what's involved. This is activity flow. There's a couple of housekeeping tasks here in white, as far as some things that have to be done to make everything work. The idea is, you know, as you know, with any automation, do your source code checkout, build everything, we build the CFS, we build the pipe, the target, configure assist, build your databases, start this, stop it, if you have to build and launch it, use assist, start with this, build servers if the way started or not, run the software, it's actually a test on the target system, stop support, stop assist, and all those results. So that's the idea. So we started one of this. This was a prototype effort back in 2014, at the end of the fiscal year. And some of that is we've had time. You know, really, there's no new mesh launch. We had no real reason to invest in this. Just for, but we've been through this release, the exploit they mentioned earlier as well, to provide a means to potentially run their tests that they're working on. Here's all the tech on this slide. I won't be able to kind of skim them, but again, you see them there. Kind of one thing that's neat is there is, we developed with this, a small business worked with us to develop a Keynote 50 model. This is the first use of that. So we actually run the bot that has been built for Red Bull in this environment. So that's kind of a unique aspect. And then I'll talk about the simulation of flight mission and NOSQ. Just like to use lots of acronyms like everybody else. I'll just explain that. So simulation of flight is a grassroots effort for the NASA TCHAT Launch Initiative. It's a joint effort between West Virginia University, NASA IBMB, TMC Technologies, businesses and small businesses in West Virginia. It is the White House maker of the only rookie team set selected in the class call for proposals. The primary objectives of this team set is basically to demonstrate all the technologies we've invested in to build simulators for large missions on a small set platform. The result result basically will be a software-only small set simulator and small skew, soft NASA operational simulator. Basically, the university, so this is kind of the test effect and you're getting the future workforce prepared. And so what we are here to provide a virtual machine to students that have EFS, the graph system, has the interface and simulated with either ARC or like a some IPC or SPI device. I can't remember what the other one was called. Busfire that then they basically have to test over action out and their instrument and then we'll integrate that with the spacecraft. Science, they come up with actually three departments, computer science, mechanical engineering, and civics. A lot of experience on the few set, anything from testing out new radiation materials to reading space weather. So, mission scheduled to launch here in probably June 2017. Make sure to give you a feel, so you've seen very similar diagrams throughout the day. Your operating system on top of that, free RTOS, MDFS, and the STF-1 apps. Jump here. Basically, Alan mentioned this earlier, we're taking a very similar approach to Dellinger. We're developing a hardware library, whereas we take the functionality to, for within the hardware. We're going to calls in there that way, based on compile options, we can either run our applications on the actual hardware, or we can actually on simulator. Simulator or not cube, basically what is it? Well, what will it be? Developer test sets for small satellites. Based on our hardware, we're using a lot of commercial hardware, very similar to the Dell Insurance series and all the cube sets. Easy interface is CFS, but CFS is not required. Currently, OpenLoop, the first version was last month. Hopefully, we're ready to run. Folks talked about this earlier. But what we want to do here is what we have is to basically migrate your bigger puppet and our solution, whereas you can basically click a button and you launch essentially your build and testing line. Right now, we're also incorporating Cosmos into that because we do, as with everybody, we just want to keep everything open source. So we're here to share what we learn, share what we do. So right ahead, you click that, launches everything, puts up your own test environment, and you're ready to go. Bring our network connectivity 15 minutes, 30 minutes, and we're at. It is going to be really executable in libraries, and then what it's used for is we're using it as software development to get started because all these hardware items and especially more of the hardware, even commercial hardware, the lead times are getting longer and longer even for small missions. Folks that are making this hardware don't have the facilities to turn around this fast. So it's basically just the schedule. I use this for testing the flight software, stressing it, and coming up with our initial test suite. Integrate for early app development and payload team integration. Like I said, I want to provide this to you. They'll be able to do their initial checkout with the environment and then mission planning. We've done VPS. Different sims to allow to do some power analysis and see how we expect things to perform. Pretty good plug for Scott. There's a couple of presentations we had later in the week, but really quickly, Scott will walk through this mission and this simulator complete details on Thursday. Try to cover quick. CFS use, then provide the static manual, dynamic analysis now, a lot of software really simulated their work, hardware-related automation, available technology that folks have already set outside of our program, and it seems like it's like key check information. If any questions, I'll take those. I'll leave the chat back there.
When is the OS3 view available for small
applications? The version, I mean, is right now. So, OpenLoop, right now, all the hardware apps are based on security hardware, which is similar to what you guys are using. So, there's no real case. So, there's no real case.
schedule meeting with Chuck and we'll come up.
Yeah, we actually just spent we have a huge slide back on what the simulator can do this, and that's off James Wood. Also last thing guys at Facebook and somewhere else too. So what was the other camera gentlemen? We're living in West Virginia, so we're writing things down. So a lot of documentation on this stuff, and yeah, we need to talk to Chuck and you and see what we can think up with the
Yeah.